Map reading is a very important skill to have. No matter how many times we'll use our smartphone to guide us around where we need to go, it will always be useful to pick up a paper map and find out where you need to go. And of course, maps have come a long way in the last few hundred years, and they can tell us all sorts of information about the land around us. This is Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning, and this is how to read a scientific map. Understanding a scientific map is much different than understanding a road map, and they are different skills, but they are equally important to the understanding of geology in particular. Just about everyone has used a paper road map at some point in their life, but there is an entirely different facet to map making that is used to provide data about the world around us. I'm going to use three maps of the same area to give an understanding on the similarities and differences between maps. National park units in the United States have a standard type of map. This is the map for Lava Beds National Monument in far northern California, and it's a very good example of a tourist map. As you can see, it's very easy to read and has lots of information on both sides. Tourist maps like this usually only show roads, trails, and important places to go, such as campgrounds or points of interest. This is a topographic map of the same area, Lava Beds National Monument. And as you can see already, it gives a lot more information. First of all, it's far larger, even though it covers roughly the same area. And this allows for more detail to be put in the map than it would if it were smaller. A topographic map, such as this one, primarily gives data about topography and the landscape. Topography is what a landscape looks like, whether it goes uphill or downhill or forms a canyon or a hill. It also gives information about all of the land surfaces, whether it's a road, a parking lot, a building, or vegetation, or bare rock. It usually gives some kind of indication, roughly, of what it looks like to be on the ground. Geologic and other scientific maps can usually be found at book depositories at research institutions such as a university library collection. This particular one is from Portland State University's library map collection. Often in geologic maps, there's text explaining the different units that are described in the geologic map. Often this is in a book, but sometimes it is printed on the map itself. This is a very large geologic map. The base map for this geologic map of Lava Beds National Monument is the same as the topographic map. What makes the geologic map noticeably different is the amount of bright colors. Geologic maps are lots of fun because they have lots of colors. Every color on a geologic map represents a different rock unit. Because Lava Beds National Monument is almost entirely basalt lava flows, all of the rock units on the geologic map are fairly easy to discern from each other. If we take a particular color on this map, for example, this pink one in the middle, we'll find that it has a section in the key and the text that describes that rock unit to the fullest extent. The code for this one is ASB. Since we know the name and the color of the rock unit shown on the map, we can find it in the key. That particular rock unit, labeled ASB, is the andesite of Shaanxian Butte. And it says here, andesite of Shaanxian Butte from the Pleistocene. Rock units in the keys of geologic maps are always labeled chronologically, such that the youngest rocks are on the top of the key, and the oldest rocks are in the bottom. Shaanxian Butte is one of the most prominent cinder cone volcanoes in Lava Beds National Monument, and so it is fitting that it has its own unit. And since cinder cone volcanoes are isolated events, they often produce their own unique lava flows different from the surrounding area. The information provided in the text about each rock unit provides all sorts of different information about the rocks, such as chemical makeup, appearance, texture, where it's found, where it may have come from, and this can all further be explained in the accompanying paper or book. Geology is mapped by hiking across the ground and looking at the rocks and trying to find which ones go to which formations. Other maps in geology that contain data are gravity maps or magnetic data maps, and basically any kind of scientific data can be applied to a map. In conclusion, scientific maps such as topographic and geologic maps are a fantastic way to easily visualize your data applied to the terrain and the landscape in a way that other scientists and members of the public can easily understand and view. This has been Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning. Thank you for watching.